It's not only unbecoming of him as a person, but it's also unbecoming of him as a, pardon my language, as a Filipino and as a Christian.
Kung paano mo tinatrato ang mga napakaganda, empowered, saka mga mabubuting kababaihan, eh, reflection yan kung paano mo tinatrato ang nanay mo. Yun lang ang masasabi ko.
Kung ito sinabi laban sa asawa ko, ano yung mararamdaman ko? Hindi ba disgusto? Hindi ba galit? I mean, he used to be a congressman. What happened to his honorable quote-unquote title that he holds? He's a lawyer. He knows what's wrong and what's right.
Meron pong mga panawagan na imbestigahan at filean ng kaso for possible disbarment case. And for me personally, there is enough ground.
So, kung may investigation, go. Because I don't think that the world or the Philippines for that matter deserves those in the profession that act like that.
Ilang po sa nang thoughts nyo dun sa kumakalat sa social media na ipa-disbar daw po si former Congressman Chong regarding doon sa sinabi niya kay First Lady.
Sa prayer rally, diba?
Oh, okay.
Ako ata pinauna nila kasi para objective yung aking pananaw. No, I just don't want to be the one to remind you of what your Bible says in treating women. I presume since it's a prayer rally and it's part of a Christian denomination. Ako, from an outsider, ang in-expect ko really is the messaging is about love, about unity, kasi that's what the Bible says, right? That's what Christianity says. And so, to have somebody there on the platform speaking about how to mistreat a specific individual, regardless whether she's the first lady or not, kasi babae siya, that is actually the exact opposite of what we, from the outside, looking at you Christians, would hope to hear from you. So, pangalawa, yung move for disbarment kay Congressman, I think yung mga ganong klaseng sentimento na sinasabi publicly using an event that you are actually, you know, that many are looking at, you know, media, it's gaining more media attention kasi connected ito doon sa kanilang leader na may mga pending cases. Both houses are also, the Senate and the House of Representatives are investigating. So, of course, maraming nakatutok dyan and using that platform to demean a particular person. In that kind of bold statement, is actually it hits straight to the sensitivity of being a Filipino. I think yung mga ganong grupo na pumupunta na gusto na lang ipa-disbar yung a certain individual, former congressman, it speaks about our collective sense of our collective sense of being a Filipino na dapat irespetuhin ang dangal ng isang babae. Narespetuhin ang dangal ng isang tao na huwag magsalita, lalong-lalo na kung ang isang event ay pinupush niya ay dapat pagmamahalan, pagrerespetuhan at unity sa bansa. Coming from a former public servant, it's not only unbecoming of him as a person, but it's also unbecoming of him as a, pardon my language, as a Filipino and as a Christian.
Sir Billy, may nagkaso na ba?
Call pa lang po.
Ah, call. Okay. I'll just answer this very short and sweet, sabi ko. Kung paano mo tinatrato ang mga napakaganda, empowered, saka mga mabubuting kababaihan, eh, reflection yan kung paano mo tinatrato ang nanay mo. Yun lang ang masasabi ko.
Before the lawyer speaks, ako naman, I've already mentioned my position on this. Ilalagay ko yung sarili ko sa sitwasyon na Kung ito sinabi laban sa asawa ko, ano yung mararamdaman ko? Kung itong tao na ito sinabi ito laban sa misis ko o sa nanay, ano yung mararamdaman ko? Hindi ba disgusto? Hindi ba galit? I mean, he used to be a congressman. What happened to his honorable quote-unquote title that he holds? He's a lawyer. He knows what's wrong and what's right. That has no place in Philippine society to do that on TV, on stage, in front of millions of Filipinos. It has no place whatsoever. And if there is any legal ground to find him, to penalize him, ako, I will support it. I will support it because I don't think there is no place in that in Philippine society.
Well, just to add, no, it pains me, no, because the one who made this statement publicly is a lawyer. One who is in the same profession, and it reflects not to the legal profession. So, having said that, meron pong mga panawagan na imbestigahan at filean ng kaso for possible disbarment case. And for me personally, there is enough ground. Because as a lawyer in a legal profession, we have this code of professional responsibility and accountability, or CIPRA. It states basically that we have duties not just to our clients, not just to the courts, but to the society in general. Yun po kasi niyang statement, no, against First Lady Marcos is a reflection that is something that is disrespectful. Not because the utterances were made against the First Lady, but this attitude reflects towards the women in general. And that is why this matter should be investigated by the proper authorities, such as the Integrated Bar of the Philippines, as well as the Supreme Court of the Philippines, so that we will uphold accountability and uphold the integrity of the legal profession.
I'd just like to add na rin, parang nakalimutan natin yan na Women's Month ngayon. And, you know, okay, quite frankly, hindi ako makaka-relate kasi single ako. Wala pang jowa, pero, I mean, the respect to women is a very universal language, no, across all populations, all religions, everything, you name it. And to disrespect one in any private setting is already bad enough. What more when you bring it to the public setting where there's media coverage, there are people watching that I'm very sure none of them expected that kind of remark coming from him as well. So as what was mentioned kanina by Congressman Jill, na it is also conduct unbecoming of a lawyer who is practicing that particular profession. So kung may investigation, go. Because I don't think that the world, or the Philippines for that matter, deserves those in the profession that act like that. I think na, you know, it really pains me. And what was mentioned kanina with DSJJ, na I'd imagine if that somebody said that to my mother, no, I'd be really enraged and disappointed. Pero again, I think that this needs to be looked into. And I hope that there are no cases that, or at least no other persons that would replicate this kind of behavior.
Nagustuhan niyo ba ang ganitong pagtalakay? Mag-follow sa Informador FB page at mag-subscribe sa Informador YouTube channel. Ang Informador ay nilikha ng mga staff ni Atty. Ricky Tumutorgo, aka Insurrecto, upang lalong lumawak ang inaabot ng pagpapalaganap ng katotohanan at labanan ang fake